Hello dear students, welcome back to our botany class. So in today's botany class, we are going to discuss few more topics, continuation of the enzyme chapter. So in that we are going to discuss first about the feedback inhibition. So let us see what is this first. So before the end product is formed, that means the substrate need to come and bind with the active site of the enzyme, then only the end product will be formed. But before this end product is going to be formed, there are several reactions that are taking place. That means a chain of reactions took place before this end product is formed. So among this chain of reactions, any one reaction is inhibiting the first reaction of the enzyme. Then such type of mechanism is called feedback inhibition mechanism. That means inhibition is nothing but it is stopping or inhibiting the activity of the enzyme. So that is a process of feedback inhibition. So coming to competitive enzyme inhibition, so here inhibitor is very similar to the substrate structurally, and this inhibitor is competing with the substrate to bind with the active site of the enzyme, then finally inhibiting the activity of the enzyme. So you can see here example. So considering the enzyme as an succinic dehydrogenase, and the substrate is a succinate, and the inhibitor is a malonate. So here the inhibitor malonate is structurally very similar to the substrate succinate, and this inhibitor malonate, it is competing with the substrate succinate to bind with the active site of the enzyme succinic dehydrogenase. So this process of competing the inhibitor with substrate to bind with the enzyme's active site, and finally terminating or inhibiting the activity of the enzyme. So this process is called competitive enzyme inhibition. So next, coming to the non-competitive enzyme inhibition, here the enzyme or the this inhibitor is forming an enzyme inhibition complex. So here the inhibitor is not competing with the substrate, but this enzyme inhibition complex is binding with the enzyme, but other than the active site, but it is not binding with the active site of the enzyme, and finally it is terminating or inhibiting the activity of the enzyme. So such process is called as non-competitive enzyme inhibition. Here there is no competition, but other than the active site, this enzyme inhibition complex is binding and finally terminating the activity process of the enzyme. Fine. So coming to the last again, that is allosteric inhibition. So this allosteric inhibition is nothing but here the inhibitor is no similar to the substrate structurally. That means there is no similarities at all from the inhibitor and substrate, but directly these are going to terminate or inhibit the activity of the enzyme. So here also you can take the example, enzyme is a succinic dehydrogenase and the inhibitor is a malonate. So this malonate inhibitor is directly inhibiting on the enzyme without any substrate involvement in this. In this way, these are the few topics regarding the enzyme. So in the next video, we will meet with a few more topics of the enzyme. Thank you.